guys, it's your boy, Barca Boy 103. Today we're going to be doing the match preview for Barcelona versus Real Betis in La Liga. That's right, Barcelona are back in league action. No midweek game, so I felt like we had like a little, you know, mini international break. But we are back now at the Camp Nou against one of the best teams in the league in Real Betis. But Barcelona have to have their sights on all 3 points. But before we get into it, make sure you guys smash that like button down below. Let's try to get the 200 likes in this video. Be very much appreciated. And also make sure you hit the subscribe button down below if you haven't already. And let's get into it. Kickoff time for this match will be taking place at 4:15 p.m. local time. So it will be the early La Liga kickoff time. And of course, this match will be taking place at the Camp Nou. And the referee for this match has also been confirmed. On the pitch will be Pablo González Fortes. And on the VAR, it will be the main man himself, Mateu Laos. Let's start off by taking a look at the league table. Barcelona are currently sat in 7th place in La Liga on 23 points. After playing 14 games, we have 6 wins, 5 draws, and 3 losses. And if you look at our last 5 games in the league, 2 wins, 2 draws, and 1 loss. But top of the table is the Real Madrid on 36 points. Barcelona are currently 13 points off the top of La Liga, but Real Madrid have now played their game in hand. They played a midweek on Wednesday against Athletic Bilbao, which they did win 1-0. So 36 points, 13 points clear of Barcelona right now, and also 7 points clear of second place Atletico Madrid on 29 points, but they have played as well one game less. They're also down on 29 as well, but played one more game more than us. And Sevilla, who of course our game in hand is against, have 5 points ahead of us on 28 points. So Barcelona is still a long way to go to reach the top 4 in La Liga, but of course Sevilla and Real Sociedad lost their game on the weekend, and we won, so we've gained some ground so far, but again, it's still a long way to go. But if you take a look at the top teams who they'll be facing this weekend, Sevilla will host Villarreal. That'll be a very difficult game. Atletico Madrid will face Real Mallorca. Should be easy 3 points. And actually, Real Madrid travel to the Anoeta to face Real Sociedad. That will be a good game to watch. And of course, all these games will be taking place tomorrow on Saturday. First is Sevilla, then Barcelona, then Atletico Madrid, and then Real Madrid. And again, looking at the table right now, it's going to be very, very close what happens this weekend. But all Barcelona can really do is focus on our own game and beat Real Betis. Now, if you take a look at Real Betis and where they're currently standing in the league table, they are currently 5th place in La Liga, 2 spots ahead of Barcelona on 27 points, 4 points ahead of Barcelona, but they have played one more game, 15 games played, 8 wins, 3 draws, and 4 losses. If you look at the last 5 games in the league, 3 wins and 2 losses. So they are coming to this match ahead of Barcelona on points and position in the league table and on better form as well. And so far during this season, they have performed very, very well to expectations. Let's now take a look at our opponents in the Real Betis. As I just mentioned, so far during this season, they have done very, very well. And so far in the league, they are ahead of Barcelona. If you take a look at their last few games in all competition and their last match, they played in the Copa del Rey on Wednesday. So they are coming to this match with, you know, playing midweek. We do have more rest than us. That will be an advantage for Barcelona, but they did win that game 4-0. And of course, they do a lot of rotation in that game, but their last league game was a 3-1 win against Levante. They beat Ferencváros 2-0 in the Europa League. They beat Elche 3-0. They lost Sevilla 2-0, and they lost 4-0 to Bayer Leverkusen in the Europa League. But the 3 matches that I want to take a quick look at and analyze is the last 3 games in the league against Levante, Elche, and Sevilla. Let's start off with that 2-0 loss against Sevilla. Now, of course, this is the Sevilla derby. It's one of the biggest games in La Liga, and they lost it 2-0 at home. If you look at their player range for this game, they had an absolute stinker of a performance, but they played in that 4-2-3-1 with Manuel Pellegrini as the manager, and there are a lot of former Barcelona players in this, you know, in their lineup. You have Bravo, Hector Bellerin, you have also have Bartra, you have a lot of former Barcelona players, but also great quality players. Nabil Fekir, who will be suspended for this game, he actually will not be playing this game. Sergio Canales, Andres Cuadrado, Rodriguez, who won the Copa America with Leo Messi, William Jose, who we linked to 1,000 times, but again, in this match, they were just not good enough. Sevilla were the much better team, and they lost the derby and lost all 3 points. Let's now take a look at their 3-0 win away at Elche. Now, in this match, pure and utter domination. Every chance they got in the first half, they scored. In the second half, they were a bit more conservative. They didn't really go for it because they didn't want to risk, you know, the comeback from Elche. Because, of course, with the stadium behind them, it will be that, you know, that opportunity can come up. But in this match, Manuel Pellegrini again set up in the 4-2-3-1. Very, very conservative. And also, Bellerin got a red card in this game as well. So they played the majority of this match with 10 men. But in the end, they got all 3 points. And if you take a look at their last game in the league, they beat Levante at home by 3-1 with a Juanmi hat-trick. He is coming into this match on hot form with 4 goals in his last 2 games, so I'd watch out for him. In this match though, again, 4-2-3-1, Bartra comes back again, former Barcelona player. Victor Ruiz, very, very good center back as well, but does, you know, not play well against Barcelona majority of the time. Nabil Fekir, who got a yellow card in this game, and he will be suspended again for this match. In this match, it was pure domination. Juanmi got a hat-trick, he played well, and again, most importantly, they got all 3 points. Now, overall, final thoughts on Real Betis. Of course, they're a very, very strong team, and they're very well managed by their current manager, of course, Manuel Pellegrini. He won the title with Man City, he coached Real Madrid, very, very experienced and good coach, and so far during the season, he has them playing very, very well. Players to look out for, to be honest, all of them. They have a lot of former Barcelona players in there, of course, coming to the Camp Nou, they want to prove a point. I watch out for them, you know, Juan Miranda, Teo, Marc Bartra, Claudio Bravo in goal, and of course, their star players up front, Sergio Canales, William Jose, Juanmi, who's on the back, you know, he's on the off of a hat-trick, he just had a hat-trick in his last game. All these players will come to the Camp Nou and try to put in performance. Now, Real Betis in the Camp Nou over the past few years have had our number. They got some wins, some draws, and of course, some losses. So they're going to come to this match knowing that they have belief that Barcelona are not playing too well and they can come and do some damage. Let's now get into Xavi Hernandez's press conference reaction. In his press conference this morning, he was asked a lot of questions by the media and some good ones as well. So let's get in and see what he had to say. Starts off by saying that each match will be a vital match due to the urgency that we have right now. Tomorrow is a final for us, and I don't think beyond that. Ansu Fati. Fati is making extraordinary effort. He wants to be there for the match against Bayern Munich, of course, but we must be cautious. The most important thing is that he's 100% fit. It'll be more than when he plays because we cannot take any more risks. It is not easy for him to be in Munich on Wednesday. Right now, the reports are he will not be playing. We'll wait and see on that. I have presented the sporting product to him. Talk about Ousmane Dembele now, and I told him that he will be a great protagonist. He is happy with the sporting project and he feels loved, but the decision is on his, on the economic issue. I no longer enter. He will decide. So he's saying that Ousmane Dembele wants to, you know, a sporting project, and he wants money as well. He's happy with the sporting project that Xavi gave him, and now it's up to the money, and that's where now Xavi's not involved is what he's saying. So we'll wait and see on that. Barcelona aspire to win everything always. Time will tell where Barcelona are. The goal is to win, and we are a team made to win and compete. On Des is one more player who has shown his commitment and enthusiasm despite having lower back pain, and that is to be appreciated. Now he's in a good shape, and he's 100% ready and fit for this match. The club worked to strengthen the team in January. It is clear that if someone comes in, it's because someone will have to leave, and that is the reality. Again, one in, one out in January is what Xavi is saying. If someone is signed, we will talk about it. I'm clear that we need someone with Barcelona's profile, but I'm not going to talk about names right now. Messi's Ballon d'Or. Firstly, I want to congratulate Alexia Putellas. As a young lady, she has already had a tremendous capacity. I'm very happy for her. Also, congrats to Pedri, who invited the whole team for dinner. But Messi's Ballon d'Or is justice. Football is fair by rewarding it to him. He didn't ask about Cavani joining in January. He said that Cavani is a great footballer, but I prefer not to talk about ones who we don't have here in our team. Barcelona, in addition to winning, we have to play well. This is the philosophy that we have at this club. This week, we worked on many things, the defensive line, the ball output. You have to understand that in football, there is always an opponent. Villarreal made things difficult for us, but we have to improve in all phases of the game. Roberto, Sergi is an example. He has been playing while being whistled by the Camp Nou and suffered for almost a year. Some being unfair to him, he was whistled at the Camp Nou, but last year, he was never 100%. I recommend him to undergo surgery. He is an example for this whole entire squad. Dembele is fine 100% physically and ready to play for this match. And even Dembele does not renew, he still has to play. I do not agree or contemplate him leaving him in the stands for the rest of the season. Big quote there from Xavi. He's saying that I don't want to send Dembele to the stands for the rest of the season if he does not renew his contract. That could be a problem. We'll have to wait and see on that. On Real Betis, he said that I really like Cuadrado, the Reno Mexican midfielder. I wanted to sign him when I was at El Sadd. He's a very important player for Real Betis, and he is the engine in that team. Frankie de Jong played an excellent game against Villarreal, and for me, he is absolutely 100% non-transferable, not for sale. And lastly, Xavi was asked a great question about how he decides the formation of the team. Did he look at the opponent, the players that we have, the system that we want to play, all that sort of stuff? He said that, in my opinion, what matters in our team is the philosophy of our playing style. We play with players that we want to press and get the ball. We may change the plan, but we are looking for numerical superiority on the playing field. This depends on circumstances of each match, but what depends is the team's philosophy. So again, he said that, look, formation doesn't really matter. We can change that based on the game, players that we have in the opponent. opponent. But the most important thing is the style of play, the philosophy, and we have to go out there and play beautiful football, dominate the game, and win the game in Barcelona style. And that concluded Xavi Hernandez's press conference reaction ahead of the match against Real Betis tomorrow. Let's now get into the lineup predictions. Gonna start with the manager, Xavi Hernandez. I'm gonna try my best to predict this lineup. I think there's gonna be a lot of big question marks around this game. Of course, we do have Bayern Munich in a do or die game in the Champions League midweek. Will he have that in mind? Will he go full strength in this match? I have gone with this lineup on the screen right now. I think I'll go with Ter Stegen in goal, a back three of Eric Garcia, Pique and Araujo, wing back being Abdi and Jordi Alba, midfield three of Busquets, De Jong and Nico, and a front two of Memphis Depay and Pablo Gabi. I think he will pick the exact same lineup that he picked against Villarreal a week ago. I can't see him making any changes, man. Coutinho's not going to come in. Ricky Puig won't come in. The big question for me is Sergiño Dest. Will he pick him at right wing back or pick him and go to a back four? Because, of course, we've been hearing a lot in the media that he does not really like Sergiño Dest. He's not really convinced by him. Other than that, though, that's only a big question mark. I think everything else is set in stone. He won't rotate, of course. We could maybe see Coutinho come in and start the game ahead of Gavi. Maybe because he has a formation change, but I think he will go with this team with the formation. And that's my line prediction for Xavi Hernandez. But let me know down in the comments below what you think Xavi will go with. Now I'm going to show you guys my lineup, what I would do if I was the Barcelona coach. And that lineup's on screen right now. I'd go with Ter Stegen in goal, a back four of Dest, Araujo, Eric Garcia, Jordi Alba, midfield three of Busquets, De Jong, and Nico, and a front three of Abdi, Memphis, and Felipe Coutinho. Now, I have gone with a back four. I think a back four, 4-3-3 in this game would counteract that 4-2-3-1 much better than the three at the back, especially being at the Camp Nou. You want to go a little bit on the front foot. 100% in this match, I would start Dest. You got to give him a run now. He's come back from injury, not played that much. Two center backs, I'm going with Araujo and Eric Garcia. I've now dropped Pique. I put him to rest because I want him in that match with Bayern Munich, fully fit, ready to go. Jordi Alba left back, of course. I'll send Alejandro Balde to Barça B, no point whatsoever. Midfield three, I've gone with Busquets, De Jong, and Nico. I want to have two box-to-box. I want to rest Gavi and also have two box-to-box. I want to be, you know, up and down energy with, you know, Canales, Cuadrado, Rodriguez in the midfield. There's going to be a lot of energy. We're going to match that. So I've gone with Busquets as the holder, De Jong and Nico as that box-to-box up and down. Pure winger and Abdi on the right. He's played so well so far in the past few games against Espanyol and Villarreal. Memphis, of course, up top because we have no one else. On the left, I have gone with Coutinho instead of Gavi to give Gavi rest because he's played so many minutes I can't even, you know, count on my fingers. And of course, we do have a decent sub for Coutinho. Of course, you can't rest Busquets. We don't have a CDM. That's understandable. Jordi Alba, Alejandro Balde is still young. But we do have a, you know, decent replacement for Pablo Gavi. So I'm going to use him. 400k a week. You can go there and start this match. And that's my lineup that I would select for this match. But let me know down in the comments below. Would you rather pick my lineup or Xavi's lineup? Time now for my score prediction. What do I believe the result will be in this match? I'm going to go with Barcelona drawing this match by 1-1, maybe a 0-0 or 2-2. I think what Manuel Pellegrini will do is come to this match not trying to lose. He'll take a draw, and of course, he'll take a win. And of course, Barcelona being at the Camp Nou, they want to go on the front foot, attack, attack, attack. I think we'll get hit on the counterattack quite a bit. And of course, with the players that Real Betis have, they will punish us. I think Xavi has to do an absolute masterclass to win this game, whether it's a 3 at the back, 4 at the back, 5 at the back, whatever. But in the end, I think Barcelona will draw this match by 1 goal or 0-0, something like that. But let me know your score predictions down in the comments below. So that was my match preview for Barcelona versus Real Betis in La Liga. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to leave a like, and of course, leave me your thoughts down below in the comments on everything we discussed. The main thing I want to first is your score prediction, and secondly, on those lineups. Would you rather pick my lineup or Xavi's lineup? Do you agree with Xavi's lineup? I think you'll go with, and also, what would you go with if you disagree with both of us? And of course, make sure you guys subscribe down below if you haven't already, and I'll see you guys some more for the live watch along. Send the mind note on the screen and come and join me watching the game with me. Follow straight after the match for my match review. So I'll see you guys tomorrow. Big game, take care, and Forza Barca. Thank you.